and this gets back to the bedrock bioethics. Fundamental principles of bioethics are, for an experimental product, which is what these are currently, in certainly in the United States, they're under emergency use authorization. They have not been approved yet in the United States. I can't speak to, it's a little unclear to me about the status in the UK. But I firmly believe that I'm of the school as a physician that your patients have the right to understand their disease and understand potential interventions and participate in decision making. It's their body. Your body doesn't belong to the state. And I'm of the opinion, as you suggest, that full and open disclosure of risks is something that not only can adults process and manage and should be able to, but I think we're obligated to have that full and open disclosure. So you speak now about adolescents. And that's a special case bioethically. If the product is not yet licensed and proven safe in an adolescent or child population, they, by definition, they are not able to provide full informed consent. They're not of the age of consent. This is fundamental. And in the specific case, there are now known disclosed risks in the adolescent population, particularly cardiomyopathy.
Mm-hmm.
Well, not so long ago, there was strong denial that there were any risks in this population, and that was kind of the group consensus and the party line, forgive me, put out by many public health professionals. I don't think, while these are still experimental vaccines, I caution that governments and health and public health professionals that are making these decisions about vaccination of adolescents in an environment where the safety database is evolving, and as we've seen, I think they are treading on very thin ice ethically, and I really counsel that it's time, past time, for us as a world community and as a public health community to take a good hard look at what we're doing here. You know, in crisis, it's easy to convince yourself of the need for extraordinary measures. And history is full of examples where we have decided to intern ethnic populations or whatever because of a perceived risk, or allow certain types of medical experimentation on populations. The Tuskegee experience in the United States is notorious. African Americans in the United States are still wary of participating in clinical research as a consequence, for good reason. And I kind of feel like we're in that same kind of ethical environment where we have to be very careful and cognizant of the decisions we're making, because in retrospect, we may regret having done so, particularly because it's self-evident that the safety database is evolving.
Yeah.
So I don't want to second guess national health authorities and their policy. It's not my job. It's not my purview. But I do feel comfortable raising a concern about the underlying bioethics and reiterating that we, in the West at least, we all can agree on these fundamental principles. For an unlicensed product that remains experimental, there has to be full and open disclosure promptly of risks to the patients in the broadest sense.